We are outside, and not just anywhere outside. We are in the backyard. Why are we in the backyard? Well,
what is up, guys? It is TS Cosplay back here again with a cosplay vlog. A vlog that happens with cosplay. And the reason of this vlog is because this weekend at Salt Lake Comic Con, Salt Lake City FanX, Salt Lake City Comic Convention FanX, whatever they want to call it now, me and my friend Brady, or Brady Moose Valdez, Moose, whatever he wants to call himself, I am obviously going like a casual punk, Miles Morales, and he is doing a multicam style, desert style Punisher.
And for that to come to fruition, we need to, where is it? Oh, we need to come to the cosplay Ark of the Covenant. Unlock this. Oh, that doesn't work. Say three Hail Marys and a bow chicka wow wow, and it is open. Please excuse the weird jumbled mess, but a couple weeks ago we did a photo shoot out in the desert. Check out the pictures at TS Cosplay on Instagram. Anyway, we are going, or more like Brady is going to be painting his armor this right here. It's got some scratches, got some dings, but we're gonna work it out. We're gonna tape it off, and we are going to paint a Punisher skull on it somehow. For those of you wondering what this is the Matrix High Speed TF3, I believe it is. Vest, chest rig in, desert tan, coyote, whatever you want to call it. Not sure. Brady can give you more details on it. I've only ever used a vest like this once, but we'll work with it and we'll figure it out. Not too sure where he wants to have the skull, but probably just like right here, but I don't know. I don't think he even knows where he wants to do the skull. I don't think he even knows how he wants to do the skull, but we'll figure it out when he gets here. And speak of the devil, he is here. Don't you think that you can knock on the door?
I'm here now.
So what is the plan then with this? Because I don't know. Are you wanting to paint so it drips like in the Netflix version? Or do you just want it to be till about like right here and use Plasti-Dip so you can peel it off? Or are you going to want, because I think if you repaint it, you won't be able to paint the cloth bits. But if you try to paint it black, it'll look fecked.
We're gonna play with it and we're gonna see. I think that I can get the look I'm going for no matter how I do it, whether we use masking tape, poster card to stencil it out, or we'll just have to play it by ear and see what happens. I'm anxious and excited, actually.
Where are we gonna get the poster card from?
Wally Mart, your local Wally Mart.
All right, well, let's go!
Let's go.
We are at Wally World, and I very seldom come here for costume stuff, but I think we found what we're looking for. What is this stuff?
It's the poster board.
What are you gonna do with this? What are you gonna do with it, Elf?
So basically, we're gonna cut out our silhouette, if you will, of the Punisher skull. I'll also draw in the eyes and the nose and everything. But what I'll do is I'll take those little mini pieces, stick them on some masking tape, trace them, basically making stickers of those little pieces. And then when I'm ready, I'll stick them onto the armor that I'm spray painting, and it'll basically leave it so that when I peel those off, those pieces will be there.
We hope.
All right.
And also, don't try anything you see at home, because we are professional screw-ups. So,
absolutely.
But usually, we haven't had anything that's gone wrong lately.
No, it's hopefully been a long time since we did anything that bad.
All right, well, onward and outward. Let's get out of this place. A hive of scum and villainy.
Oh, we need paint.
Don't you push me this way. All right, paint it is. Brady, found the paint. That was unnecessarily loud, but we found the paint. I don't know. Let's see what their selection for plastic is. I don't think they have dip anymore. Huh, wild. Or maybe I'm just mistaken, it's down here. Nope, it's right here. Yeah, their Plasti-Dip is cheap, but they have red and gray. Who just needs red and gray paint? What the heck? Anyway. Good old Rust-Oleum, sponsored, so. We're sponsored by Rust-Oleum Brady.
No, we're not.
Use code like TS Cosplay for 0% off of your Rust-Oleum product, even though that's Krylon.
Wait, plus Krylon.
Sponsored by Krylon. So
Rust-Oleum.
Sponsored.
American Accent. American Accents. 2x Ultra Cover Paint and Plus Primer.
Paint Plus Primer. All right.
Let's get Ultra Matte. All right,
let's get the hell out of here. So we got all the stuff from Walmart. Unfortunately, I don't know. I just get a bad vibe whenever I'm in Walmart, but they had everything we needed.
True statement. I'm not a big fan of Walmart either. I just know they have the stuff I need, so I just go there because I know it's there.
And I usually just go to Joanne, by the way, hashtag sponsored. Use code TSCosplay for 0% off your order. But yeah, we got the stuff and we're going to go home and try to figure out how we're going to do this. Hurry up!
Fuck you.
So, it's been like 100 hours since we got the stuff and really started drawing. So, where would you say we are in the process of, Brady? How do you think we will get this finished today?
Absolutely. It's just taking time and patience, as all good things do.
You know what's sad is that this looks really cool as its own. This would be a really cool Punisher picture.
Yeah, I don't know.
But all good things must come to an end.
Eventually.
So, yes, we are using a food cutting board right now because, well,
what else would you? Well, I mean, what else would you use? It doesn't matter what you use to cut on.
True.
At the end of the day, you just don't cut any item.
But anyway, so after this, we have to mask this off. And then, yes, that's food. Mask this off, and then paint the skull, and then I think that'll be it.
Yeah, pretty much.
The fun stuff. All right, we will see you guys in, like, another 3 hours. So we finally got, or Brady, finally got it drawn and cut out and ready to mask. So I guess we're gonna mask and then paint. Let's get to it. So whilst masking, dearest Brady Valdez, what are some tips? What is the way you do? Because I know obviously you can tell you go to extremes.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm kind of like in a sense, like I feel like you can't over mask simply because the better the seal you get on everything, the more you cover everything, the less overspray you're gonna get. And that's kind of what you're going for. I mean, like, I guess it depends what kind, like, what you want from the stencil. If you want some overspray, give it that more, I don't know, just at home done look. You can go with that. But if you want, like, really sharp edges and everything, it's a lot better to get more of the mask down and cover more so you don't have overspray all over your gear and it doesn't look like you're, you know, I don't know. It just depends on the look you're going for. But I like to over mask. I like the sharp lines and the sharp edges and I don't want excess paint all over. Also like to do a lot of layers, just really seal off because I'm sure some of you out there have had that problem where you don't get a good enough seal on the tape and some of that overspray makes it underneath and you've got these really random spots on there, if you will.
Just like on this, I was afraid of that stuff, and there's still, I think, I don't know, you can't really tell. There's still some masking tape everywhere, and it's good to be finding masking tape. Like, I don't know, this is my fault because I didn't prep it the right way, but I still wanted some black showing through because I didn't want it to be like blinding white. But anyway, I find it good to have like leftover masking tape found in nooks and crannies because that means you got it enough.
Right, absolutely. I agree.
All right, well, I guess we'll come back to it when we're actually painting. So Brady's just finishing up some last minute masking, and I went out to go get the painting table, and I remembered I wanted to put this on video, but if you're ever painting anything, whether it be hand painting, whether it be spraying with a giant gun, or with wherever it is, rattle can, I suggest always using rubber gloves because it's more of a hassle to try to clean off your hands with whatever color paint you're using than it is just to swap out gloves every coat you do. So we're gonna be rocking these, and yeah, just thought I'd add that little bit of advice. What say you?
I completely agree. I hate Misty Hills after doing all this crap. All
right, well, table's set up. Got to see if we can. Yeah, let's freaking go.
Basically what we're going for right now, and I know that some of you are better painters than me, is what I'm going for right now is that nice wet look. The reason for that is the foam that we're painting on is absorbent. So once I know that I see that wetness, that moisture, that I've sprayed it enough to where that first base layer isn't just gonna soak right in and basically mean nothing. I just noticed that the color won't be as dark when you avoid that. So I don't know.
And it's a good thing too, because this is also paint and primer. It's the first time I've ever used anything like this.
All right, that should be good for our first layer.
All right.
We'll go grab some food and come back and check it out.
Alrighty-ho. So we just got back from getting food, and it's still kind of wet around the eyes, the nose, and then on some of the metal. But I think we're gonna peel it just to see how it looks. We finished, or Brady finished it. Went, got some food. As I said in the last clip, whatever, we ended up bringing it in, peeling all the masking off, and here is what we are rocking with. I dig the heck out of it. Couldn't have done it any better myself.
No, you couldn't have.
Wow, gosh. Anyway, here's how it looks. I really dig it, especially the black overspray on the sides. I think that looks really freaking cool. And then this, obviously, that's not dry. That's not dry. That's not dry.
The drip, however, was intentional. I definitely wanted that drip in there.
It looks freaking sick. I dig it. Lift it up. See how it looks. As if we're at a convention. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Oh, whoa, it's the Punisher. And he's wearing tan? What? But anyway, I really dig it. I think it looks cool. Brady will be running around in this at Salt Lake City Fan X. This week. And then before that, we're gonna do a full loadout video for this costume. He's gonna be wearing a ton more gear and whatnot. He'll have his hair all trimmed up and whatnot and hoorahs. But it'll be a pretty cool video. Keep your eyes out for that. What version of this? What version of Punisher are you naming this?
You can call it a multicam. I'm just gonna call it a combat overseas combat Punisher.
Okay, well, I guess that'll do it for this video. Like I said, keep your eyes out for the loadout video. And yeah, see you guys in the next one.
Sorry, I didn't even know you were filming me.